Almost every day after elementary and high school, I took this walk to my house. Rain, shine, or even snow. Didn't really matter. I didn't care. I made it a point to go to Slipdisc Records whenever possible. Buy a bunch of CDs. I got almost every CD I own there. My Megadeth, my Anthrax, my Shadows Fall, my Slayer, everything. Iron Maiden, Judas Priest, didn't matter. If I wanted it, they had it, and that's why I bought it.
Was it last out on the throne? It's been picked clean to the bone. It's so hard to remember.
Running Slipdisc has always been a dream job for me, getting to meet a lot of bands and people from the in-stores to customers and the friendships that have been built. It's something I've always wanted to do. For the last 25 years, I've been able to do it. I decided in 81, like 6 months before I actually opened the store, and I was a big music fan, music collector, and I've worked in management positions and just decided to save up money and do something that I loved, and that was running a record store. I think the people that shop at Slipdisc are collectors as opposed to people that are just looking for, you know, top 10 hits, or they're people who just really love the music and want the packaging and just collect. Basically, we kept the store the same as it is now, very old school, and it was really just the format that was different, not the music. Heavy metal pays the bills. We do sell, you know, all facets of rock, but heavy metal is always what this store has been about, specializing in metal. Oh, it's definitely a loyal fan base. I mean, besides Long Island, we have people coming from Connecticut. I mean, back then, Massachusetts. We just got a letter from someone who used to travel, like from Rhode Island, once a month to come and load up on stuff. So it's definitely a loyal fan base.
Slipdisc is basically the coolest store in town. You can go get any CD you want.
CDs, EPs, t-shirts, you would never see this anywhere.
Slipdisc kind of got me into the better metal, such as Ozzy and Black Sabbath.
It's like a little place and you know all the people there.
It's a heavy metal paradise. This is the only place that you can go where you can just basically be metal.
Any musicians shopped in Slipdisc?
A lot. I mean, on days of in-stores, obviously, the bands would be into shopping after the in-store was over, but we used to have members of Anthrax shop, and Napalm Death, and have a lot of regular customers who are, you know, major musicians. Mike Portnoy from Dream Theater. Started shopping in the store when he was like 12, and the most memorable was probably Metallica, just because of, you know, the status that they reached. And I mean, the most memorable for me was Motorhead, just because I'm a big Motorhead fan. And We do specialize and carry a lot of imports and just harder to get stuff. So we do get, you know, people from out of the area. And the chain stores, you know, with the downloading, it affected them the greatest just because it's more of a top 100 kind of crowd going in there, and they seem to be buying music, you know, downloading or buying a certain song that they like. Here it's people that like truly collect. Now you just have a lot more releases, and the quality is not always there. You know, back in the day, in the 80s, there was just less coming out and a little more quality. Now there is so many different kinds of rock music that you really have to keep up with it and see what people are looking for and asking for. We do have our own website now. So we do compete with those bigger stores and stores that are online. But we also just carry a different kind of product, and it doesn't really seem to affect us that much.
Do you think there'll always be a place for mom and pop record stores?
I think there'll always be a place for it, a need for it, but whether, you know, they can survive, you know, the times, you know, the problem with the music industry right now is another question. I mean, that's why you see so many going out of business right now. They just can't survive in today's music world. But to me, there's always going to be that need. There's always people that are going to want to go into a store and shop rather than just go online.